Unless you've been living under a rock or in a cave, hidden away from the sun, you know that this Monday is a big day here in North America. That's because, well, the sun will be hiding from us for a few minutes. The 2024 solar eclipse is just around the corner, a total eclipse in some parts of New England. Here to get curious with us about it is Edgar B. Herwick III, the guy behind GBH's Curiosity Desk.
Hello.
Hi, Edgar. Good to see you again.
Good to see you. Are you into this? Are you really excited about this eclipse?
I could not be more excited about this. I grew up in the space business, so anything involving astronomy, anything like that, that is my jam.
Pretty fantastic. Yeah, so again, just, you know, as a reminder, this is Monday. It's going to happen, you know, around 2 to 4:30-ish. And here in the greater Boston area, people are going to be at like 90 to 92% totality or something like that. So most of it's going to get covered. But just north of us, there will be a full total solar eclipse. Lots of cities on it too, right? Like San Antonio, Dallas, Indianapolis, Cleveland, and then of course places in New Hampshire, Vermont, and Maine.
So this is pretty rare. When is the next total eclipse hitting the United States?
Well, it's interesting that you asked that, because I've worked up a little bit of trivia here, and I thought this is going to be fun, because what I'm thinking is this is eclipse-related, but it's not really necessarily the science of it. This is, I'm thinking, people, while the eclipse is happening, they can kind of pull this trivia out on their friends and stuff.
Okay.
I thought maybe if you would like to be the guinea pig and, like, sort of go through it with me.
Always.
Great. So you asked, first question, is it true or false? We're going to do all true or false today, all right? So true or false, another full solar eclipse will occur in 2079 with Boston proper in the path of totality this time.
Oh, wow. So the next one in the United States is 2044, but I don't know anything about 2079. So I will guess true, because it's such a strange year to pick.
It is absolutely true. And it's interesting because, you know, people talk about a full solar eclipse as a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, right? But for younger Bostonians, many of them will be around in 2079. And in fact, if you're willing to move from place to place, total solar eclipses are not that uncommon. There's a bunch of them coming up if you're willing to go to different places. We just see a list right here. We got one in 2026, 2027, 2028, 2030, 2033, 2034. None of them in the U.S., or I think most of them not in the U.S. I think Alaska will get a part of one. But other places in the world, if you want to see one, you can do it in your lifetime.
Awesome.
All right, want to do another one?
Absolutely.
All right, number two, true or false? This one's going to have to do with the moon. There is always a full moon on the evening of a total eclipse. Is that true or false? Always a full moon on the evening of a total solar eclipse.
Well, the evening makes me feel like you're tricking me, but it has to be a full moon for an eclipse. I'm going to say yes.
So that
true.
Would be no, it is false. It's the exact opposite. So it's always a new moon.
A new moon.
The first phase of the moon is the new moon. And so it's always a new moon when you've had an eclipse. That's just sort of like where it is in its phase.
So it's always a full moon for a lunar eclipse.
That is probably
That's what it
true.
Is, yeah.
That is probably true. So there you go.
Okay.
All right. Number three. Want to do another one? Here we go. Staying on moons, but this time we're going to kind of move away from the Earth. So true or false? False. On Mars, full solar eclipses are much more common than here on Earth because Mars has two moons.
So Mars does have two moons, but Phobos and Deimos are really small.
Phobos and Deimos.
So I'm going to go with no, because I don't think they're big enough to block out the sun.
You have nailed it 100% across the board. You're right on the names of the two moons, which of course are named after two Greek twin god characters, both different kinds of fear, right? One of them is like terror, and the other one is like panic or something like that. They are both very small moons. And so while there are a lot of eclipses that happen, they are always partial because the moons are not big enough to actually cover the sun relative to somebody who would theoretically be standing on the surface of Mars. Now, apparently the big event on Mars, the big, like, sort of this barely ever happens kind of eclipse, is when one of those moons eclipses the other moon. So that apparently is a very rare occurrence, but that does happen.
Well, someday somebody will get to see that.
Hopefully. Fingers crossed we can get to Mars someday for something like that. All right, you got one more in you?
Absolutely.
All right, we're sort of going to shift out of science and into arts and culture in this one. Okay, so true or false? Are you familiar with the 1983 Bonnie Tyler hit Total Eclipse of the Heart?
I mean, I've heard it.
Very famous song, very famous song. So your true or false question is, that 1983 Bonnie Tyler hit single, Total Eclipse of the Heart, was written by the same songwriter behind I Would Do Anything for Love by Meatloaf and It's All Coming Back to Me Now by Celine Dion. So true or false, the same songwriter wrote all three of those tunes.
I mean, they all have kind of the same style.
Don't they?
So I will go with true.
It is absolutely true. And the songwriter is a songwriter named Jim Steinman. And there's a little bit of a local story here because he went to Amherst College. So that's where he got his bachelor's degree in 1969. And apparently, like, essentially his senior project, what he got a bunch of his, like, credit for in his senior year, was writing a musical. And this musical was called, it was called Dream Engine. And it's like a dystopian 1969 or whatever. But there's a song in that musical, which is called Formation of the Tribe. And that is where the line, Turn Around Bright Eyes, originates. So that famous line as part of the song, Total Eclipse of the Heart, Turn Around Bright Eyes, stretches all the way back to a different song he wrote in 1969 in a play at Amherst College.
And so where are you going to see this eclipse, Edgar?
So I'm going to be covering this for GBH for the Culture Show. If people check that out on the radio, I'm going to be in St. Johnsbury, Vermont, which is in the path of totality. Small town about 3 hours outside of Boston. But they punch above their weight with cultural institutions, including a science museum. So they got a big sort of program prepared. And they're expecting anywhere from 5,000 to 10,000 people to come into this small town and be there for the event. I will be among them, and we'll be doing some reporting from up there.
Well, Edgar, I'm really jealous because that sounds amazing, and I
very excited.
Look forward to hearing in person from you all about what it was like when the skies go dark in the middle of the day.
I will give you the full report.
Thanks very much, Edgar B. Herwick III. Thank you for joining us today.
Always a pleasure.